Good morning. My name is Tom Edwards. I'm the Vice President of the New York State Liquor Store Association, and I'm happy to welcome all of you here today and introduce the launch of another of our campaigns to promote New York State wines. Fall in love with New York wines, you see in the posters here. We also have a nice holiday promotion right after the fall promotion that's coming up. To my right is Jeff Saunders, the founder of Last Door on Main Street and the creator of these campaigns. I have Yancey McGlory from White Cliff Vineyards. I have Karen Gardy from Brookview Station Vineyards. And I have Scott Fink, a retailer from New York City who has a tremendous wine selection, a New York wine selection, right in the heart of New York City. I also want to point out that I have Don Bombase in the audience and Tim Sweeney. This is some major retailer commitment. Don came in this morning from the Finger Lakes region. He's also a former winner of Retailer of the Year from the New York Wine and Grape Foundation, so there's another amazing New York wine collection there. And Tim Sweeney is at a business conference at Turning Stone, left the conference to be here today and is heading back as soon as we're done this morning. I wanted to also remind you that our promotions are not taxpayer funded. This is all retailer based. This comes from our work with the wineries and roundtables and discussions about how retailers and wineries can better promote the New York brand. And there are amazing winemakers in the state of New York, and we're proud to promote them, and we're proud to sell them at our establishments. And we are thrilled that the governor and our legislature are really starting to pay attention and know that this is a burgeoning industry and that we should really do what we can to codify it and make it one even more successful than it is today. So without further ado, I'd like to introduce you to our Senator Kathy Young. She's been a champion of ours, a champion of the wine industry, and we look forward to working even more with her and her team to get New York wine promoted. My pleasure.
Thank you and good morning. I am absolutely thrilled to be here today to help promote this effort, this partnership between the retailers and the wine industry. And right now in Chautauqua County, which I represent, it's harvest time and the smell of grapes fills the air. I can't think of a better time to do this promotion of our wines in New York State. From Long Island to Lake Erie, we have some of the finest wines in the entire world. It's a $400 million a year industry. And I believe so strongly that New York State should do all that it can to help that industry thrive and grow. And so my hat is off to the retailers for their initiative today. It's a private sector effort, as Tom pointed out, but it's a way to promote our New York State wines even further. You know, this is about marketing and branding and consumer education. And that's where the retailers can be so helpful, because we want the consumers to come in and say, when they shop, I want a Cabernet from Long Island or the Hudson Valley or a Riesling from the Finger Lakes or the Chautauqua region. And quite frankly, that doesn't happen as often as it should right now. So this is a way to grow the market and grow our economy in New York State. And I really am excited and enthused about Governor Cuomo's initiative as far as having the Beer and Wine Summit, because both of those industries are ones that we should cultivate. And this not only helps our retailers, and not only helps our wineries, it also helps our farmers, our growers, our agriculture industry, which is still one of the top industries in New York State. I can't think of a more productive effort than the one today. I want to thank the wineries for your commitment to our economy, to New York State. You produce wonderful wines. We just want the world to know, and this is a way to do it, to fall in love with New York wines.
Thank you, Senator. I'd also like to let everyone know that we have a staff member from Assemblyman Cahill in the audience as well. It's Connor Bambrick, and the Assemblyman has also been a big champion of the wine industry, and we'd like to thank you as well for being here today. With that, I'd like to introduce Yancey McGlory from Wycliffe.
Hi, it's a pleasure to be here. I wanted to thank the governor and the senator and the retailers for all of the efforts to work with us. Wycliffe got started 13 years ago making 450 cases of wine, and this year we're up to 6,000 cases. We've actually doubled in size over the last few years and built one of the first geothermal wine processing buildings in the state, and we couldn't achieve that kind of growth without support from the retailers. It's just key, and we've seen a lot of improvements in very recent years in a good reception for New York wines, even in New York City, and that's in no small measure thanks to the efforts of the Retailers Association. We are making great wine, as the senator said. We really are. Wycliffe actually took best white in show in the San Francisco International Wine Competition 2 years ago, which means we beat wines from all over the world in a blind tasting, and too many people don't realize how great our wines are. So we really appreciate all the different efforts that are going into helping this industry grow. There are many new players coming into it making wine, and the efforts working with the governor to make the regulatory climate less mind-boggling for small new business owners will help keep that going. Thank you.
Thank you, Yancey, and yes, thank you for your wine. We do enjoy it. Karen.
Thank you, Tom. I'm Karen Gardy from Brookview Station Winery over at Gould Orchards. I too would like to thank Governor Cuomo and Senator Young for all of their help in promoting wineries. Our Brookview Station Winery was started as a value-added product of Gould Orchards, and that would not have been possible without a state economic grant from Ag and Markets. So for us, it's vitally important that all across the state, agriculture, wine industry, gets funded and we promote it. I also am on the board of Hudson Valley Wine Country, and that is the branding organization, and we represent all of the wineries in the Hudson Valley. Most of you don't know that Hudson Valley is the largest growing region in the state. We have the most wineries here, and it is the oldest wine growing region in the country, and we're very proud of that fact. And we're looking forward to the opportunity to promote that, not just in and around New York State, but to the country and to the world. Thank you both.
Thank you, Karen. Scott Fink.
Hi, how you doing? I'm Scott Fink from McAdam Byright of Astoria, Manhattan. Early in the 80s, my father took it upon himself to start helping promote local wines. We have about 200 New York State wines now. And the best thing I can say is you have a wonderful product. The New York State wines are as good as any other wines we sell in the store. But the majority of the people that are trying the wines have had it because they had it at a winery, and they say, oh, I tasted it at the winery. If we do a tasting in the store, the wines do great at the tasting. We'll sell more during that tasting than we would of tasting a California wine. But if you ask the number of New Yorkers how many of you have tried a New York wine, that number's not quite as high. And with the governor and senator getting behind us, I think that we can really get the message out there that New York's got great wines. And if people try them, they like them. It really is that simple. I mean, it'd be a hard sell if people didn't like the wines, but you already have wines people like. So, you know, we just need to get the message out there. So, thank you.
Just to sum it up, New York with the $400 million what the wine brings in, $400 million worth of revenue, it's New York's best kept secret. And hopefully the purpose of this summit is so it's not a secret any longer. Thank you.
Thank you, Jeff. With that, we certainly open to some questions. Well, we've done a great job. Have a good day.